Taiwan is poised to become the latest buyer of the battle-tested National Advanced Surface-to-Air Missile Systems, or NASAMS, following U.S. approval for its sale. The acquisition of this system would significantly enhance Taiwan's air defense capabilities as it seeks to counter the increasingly sophisticated threat posed by Chinese aircraft, missiles, and drones. The Defense Security Cooperation Agency, or DSCA, announced last week that the State Department had approved the potential sale of the NASAMS package to Taiwan. The deal could be worth as much as $1.16 billion. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the U.S.-made NASAMS could help Taiwan thwart Chinese aggression. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The agreement consists of 3 NASAMS systems, each of which includes an AN/MPQ-64F1 Sentinel radar. Other related hardware comprises an undisclosed number of fire distribution centers (FDC), canister launcher systems (CLS), electro-optical infrared (EOIR) systems, and tactical control center (TCC) systems. Up to 123 AIM-120 advanced medium-range air-to-air missiles, extended range or AMRAM-ER, is included in the deal. Supporting equipment consists of multifunctional information distribution systems (MIDS) and MIDS Link 16 capable radios, IPX-250X high insurance internet protocol encryptions (HAIPE), KIV-77 identification friend or foe (IFF) systems, AN/PSN-13 defense advanced global positioning system (GPS) receivers (DAGR). It's important to note that foreign arms sales approved and announced by the DSCA are not final and may change, including due to negotiations between the purchasing country and the involved defense contractors. The Norwegian company Kongsberg Defense and Aerospace teamed up with Raytheon and initiated the NASAMS program as a cooperative effort for the Royal Norwegian Air Force. The network-centric air defense system NASAMS was declared fully operational capable in 1998, but had an initial operational capability as early as 1994 or 1995. In mid-2006, the Royal Norwegian Air Force, together with Kongsberg Defense and Aerospace, executed a midlife update of NASAMS to add Link 16. As well as a better ground radar. Over time, many upgrades were made. Probably unknown to most Americans, NASAMS is the main surface-to-air missile system in the National Capital Region, including Washington, D.C. It's part of a layer setup and is augmented by AN/TWQ-1 Avenger short-range air defense systems, which are deployed at important locations. A NASAMS battery consists of 12 missile launchers, LCHR, each one carrying 6 AIM-120 AMRAM missiles, 8 radars, AN/MPQ-64 Sentinel F1 X-band 3D radar, 1 fire control center (CTOC), 1 electro-optical camera vehicle (MSP-500), and 1 tactical control cell (TCC) vehicle. The mobile launcher can be deployed and remotely controlled up to 25 kilometers or around 15.5 miles away from the fire control center. Each launcher can fire the 6 AMRAMs in seconds against 6 different targets, enabling multiple simultaneous engagements. Since 12 launchers are present, With 6 missiles each, the system can engage up to 72 targets simultaneously. The AN-MPQ-64 Sentinel is a 3D radar used to alert and cue short-range air defense (SHORAD) weapons to the locations of hostile targets approaching their frontline forces. It's an X-band range-gated pulse Doppler radar system. The antenna uses phase frequency electronic scanning technology, forming sharp 3D pencil beams covering large surveillance and track volume. The radar automatically acquires, tracks, classifies, identifies, and reports targets including cruise missiles, unmanned aerial vehicles, and both rotary and fixed-wing aircraft. It uses a high scan rate, 30 RPM, and operates at a range of 40 kilometers or 25 miles. The radar is designed with high resistance to electronic countermeasures (ECM). Mounted on a towed platform, it can be positioned remotely from the rest of the unit, operated autonomously, and communicate with the Fire Direction Center (FDC) via a wideband fiber optic link. It can also distribute its data over a SINGCAR's radio network. NASAMS is compatible with several missiles like Infrared Homing, AIM-9X Sidewinder, and IRIS-T missiles, as well as different variants of AMRAAM. The AMRAAM AIM-120 was developed early in the 1990s and is best known as an air-launched fire-and-forget missile deployed on the F-16, F-A-18, F-22, Eurofighter, and JAS-39 Gripen, to name a few. Designed specifically for NASAMS, the AMRAAM-ER that Taiwan could get combines elements of the RIM-162 Evolved Sea Sparrow Missile (ESSM) and newer versions of the AIM-120 AMRAAM. The missile offers a significant boost in maximum range and engagement altitude over a standard AIM-120 fired from a NASAMS launcher. With standard AMRAAM, NASAMS is capable of engaging targets up to a range of 20 miles or 32 kilometers away and an altitude of 1,000 feet to 50,000 feet. AMRAAM-ER increases the range by 50% and the ceiling by 70%. NASAMS, which is battle-tested in Ukraine, is a very good option for Taiwan. The system is capable of engaging various aerial threats, making it particularly effective for intercepting cruise missiles and one-way attack drones, key weapons that China might use in strikes against Taiwan. Under certain conditions, the system also has limited capabilities against short-range ballistic missiles. NASAMS can be integrated into a broader Integrated Air Defense System (IADS) that incorporates different sensors and weapon platforms, which is especially valuable for Taiwan given its complex defense needs in response to the Chinese threat. A significant advantage of NASAMS is its ability to launch AMRAAM missiles as well as AIM-9X Sidewinders, both of which are already stocked for use by the Republic of China Air Force (ROCAF) F-16 fighters. So the logistics will be easier. Taiwan will just need to bulk up its inventory of AMRAAM and AIM-9X Sidewinders, which could be used by its F-16s, as well as NASAMS. The proposed deal is in line with the U.S.'s aim to make Taiwan a porcupine, agile and hard to attack. China has noted this development, and its foreign ministry said, "China will take resolute countermeasures and take all measures necessary to firmly defend national sovereignty, security, and territorial integrity."
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.